Hi guys, welcome back to Marvel Fever. You might have seen our previous episode, The Marvel's Royal Battle. And this episode, let us know about Iron Man's new armor in Infinity War. In Avengers Infinity War, we are going to see Iron Man's new armor, the Bleeding Edge. This was also officially announced by Weekly Entertainment Magazine. They introduced the Bleeding Edge in comics in Invisible Iron Man issue 25. In Tony Stark Max, it is the most advanced one. Once Tony created a suit, thought it was the most advanced one, but he gave it to Peter Parker, and now it would be less advanced than Bleeding Edge. He added Unibeam player source energy in the Bleeding Edge. It materializes on Tony's body. We have seen this in the TV spot. In this TV spot, it materializes like organic exoskeleton. That too marvelous. It have got many likes also. Till now, Tony has less materializes armor. Bleeding Edge armor is the next step for Extremis armor in comics. This is an unibody suit for Tony. He connected it mentally. We can't see any of the Extremis armor in Marvel Cinematic Universe, because they have not shown it till now, but they showed advanced mode of it in Avengers Infinity War, but not showed Extremis armor in any of the Iron Man movies, except in Iron Man 3. In comics, Tony builds Bleeding Edge armor with nanotechnology and Bleeding Edge technology, but in trailer, we saw still more advanced technique like rocket boosters. These rocket boosters are very powerful and helps Tony to go to even space. In Marvel's The Avengers, we have seen that with a great difficulty Tony goes to space, but now it would not be that difficult like in Avengers. He would be just flushing to the space. When armor doesn't work there, and now his armor is completely ready. This armor look like Mark 51 Prime armor and has Model 55 space armor features. When we see this suit materializing, it looks somewhat like Black Panther suit materializing. But when comparing this armor, Shuri, who created Black Panther suit, stays backward, as Tony Stark is the best one. This was rumored that the suit was made by Wakandian technology and by Vibranium, but it was not true. Tony alone creates his suit. We can see them in Infinity War comics also. Now let us know about what the technology is used in this suit. This is also so interesting. Number 1. Extremis nanotechnology. It is present in Tony's body. It is controlled by Tony's mind. When he needs it, it comes out automatically, and then when he doesn't need it, it goes out. Just like Tony removes his clothes and changes his clothes. Number 2. Arc reactor. Arc reactor is also another important feature in this one. Tony throws away his arc reactor in Iron Man 3, but according to comics, he gets back his reactor and builds his new armor. It is the ability to have clash with Vibranium also. It can defeat Vibranium also. In Age of Ultron, we have seen Tony Stark melting Ultron's body with the help of Vision Stones and a normal sword. Then think how powerful if he with a high beam source arc reactor. Now we will discuss more about this arc reactor. This arc reactor is so powerful. Number 3. Self-repairing technology. We have seen self-repairing technology for Iron Man. This is the main feature for his armor. It is also healing Tony until he uses the arc reactor. Number 4. Weapons. Weapons is the another most important thing in this. This armor has got many weapons like repulsors, energy blasts, and cannons. He can obtain different weapons he wants. Recently, we have seen in TV spots, he changes his weapon into a sword and blasts into space. Whatever weapon he imagines in his mind, he can get that type of a weapon. He is so ultimate. Number 5. Repulsors. We can see so many repulsors which help Tony to see his enemies in 360 degrees with the help of repulsors and cameras. If you like it, this is all about the Iron Man's new body and new suit, Bleeding Edge armor. Thank you for watching.